There are a lot of data visualization tools out there. It could be an overwhelming task to decide which one in particular suits your needs. Grafana is open source and could be installed on your machine within minutes to play with and determine if the visual appeal works for you in your company. This video is for data analysts, data scientists, and just anyone who would like to get a glimpse into Grafana. And in my next video, I will show you how to create your first Grafana dashboard. Let's go! Hello and welcome to Volkov Labs YouTube channel. Installation of Grafana is quite a smooth exercise. You have two options. You can install Grafana directly on your machine or using container technology. I will show you both. And as a spoiler alert, I recommend the second one. Let's start with the direct installation. Go to the Grafana.com website, open source menu, then select Grafana. Find the Get Grafana button, choose Self-Managed option, and then click Download Grafana link. Or you can use the link from the description box down below. By default, they suggest the latest stable version and Enterprise Edition. This is exactly what you need, nothing to change here. Next, select your operating system. For Windows, you download and run the installer. Here is what the installation looks like for Windows. For Mac, you would open Terminal and run curl command to download the file, and then tar command to extract all files from the archive. Here is how those steps are going to look like on Mac. That's it! Now you run Grafana by going into your browser and typing localhost 3000, the username and password admin. This was your first option when you install Grafana directly on your machine. There is another better option, and for that you would need a Docker container. Docker is an open source project for self-sufficient containers that can run on the cloud or on premises. What that means is Docker helps you to simulate many machines on just one, and you can make them work with each other as if they are a network. I love this technology because Docker container does not leave a trace in my system. Once I'm done with the container, I simply can remove it like it never existed before. To work with Docker containers, you would need Docker Desktop. Search for Install Docker Desktop on Windows or Mac, then click the link and follow the instruction for installation. Here is what Docker Desktop looks like after it is installed. Now let's get back to the Grafana website and select Docker option. They give you only one command since Docker is capable of determining which system you are on. Copy and execute this command to download the Grafana container. Now let's get back to Docker Desktop to make sure our freshly downloaded Grafana container is there and hit Run button if it's not yet running. You can also check the list of existing containers by running Docker PS command. That's it! Now go to your browser and type localhost 3000, user and password admin. As a pro tip, while experimenting with Grafana, you might want to install it multiple times, as I did while I was preparing this video. Using Docker containers, you can have as many Grafanas on your machine as your machine resources allow. Let me show you how. When you run this command, -p attribute is for port specification. Here you are mapping the ports of your machine to a container port. I am assigning the port of 3000 on my machine to a Grafana container. By specifying any other number, I can install Grafana container on another port. Just make sure this port is not yet used by any other service. Let me run this command for you. Here I'm mapping 3001 on my machine to Grafana container. Now let's check our Grafana desktop and find another Grafana container installed on the port 3001. In the browser, I type localhost 3001 and here you go, brand new Grafana for my experiments is ready. If this video was helpful, as a thank you, give us thumbs up. Check out our description box below for more info. Thanks for watching and see you next time.